In this video, we'll show you where you can get all the data you need absolutely free. And don't worry, you're not gonna go to prison. Hi, my name's Tom. I've been working in data for over 5 years, and I'm a senior data scientist at Career Foundry. At Career Foundry, I spend most of my time working with our own company data, but in my spare time, there's nothing I love more than working on personal projects, and for those projects, I really find it useful to have access to free open source datasets. We at Career Foundry have curated 10 places for you to find free datasets, coming from a variety of sectors, from e-commerce to environmentalism, and containing a wide variety of types of data, from physics to photography. All of which will allow you to showcase your skills, build a portfolio, and eventually get hired as a data analyst. If you're starting out in data analytics, chances are you're struggling to find access to good data. Maybe you've worked for companies with good data before, but you don't have access to that data anymore. Maybe you haven't worked with APIs before, so you don't know how to pull data from those sources. And maybe your web scraping skills aren't up to scratch to directly mine for data. Fortunately, there are tons of free datasets available, and we're sharing the top 10 places where you can find those datasets next. Let's start by looking at the first example now. Google Dataset Search. Launched in 2018, Google Dataset Search is like Google Search Engine, but specifically for data. Google Dataset Search aggregates data from multiple sources, provides a clear summary of what's available, a description of the data, who it's provided by, and when it was last updated. It's an excellent place to start. Native Python Datasets. Python has some awesome datasets already built into many of the packages commonly used by data analysts and data scientists. Of course, you'll need basic Python skills to obtain them, but once you've got those, the possibilities are endless. My three personal recommendations are scikit-learn, a package for doing scientific and quantitative research. Seaborn, a package for doing awesome visualizations. TensorFlow, a package for building and training deep neural networks. Kaggle, like Google Dataset Search, Kaggle offers aggregated datasets, but it's a community hub rather than just a search engine. Since its launch in 2010, it has evolved into a renowned open source data platform, offering online collaboration for data scientists and data analysts alike, as well as educational tools for teaching data analytics and artificial intelligence. Plus, of course, tons of great datasets covering any problem you can imagine. Plus, you can win tons of money if you solve their problems. But be prepared, they're not that simple. Datahub.io. Datahub has datasets covering a wide variety of topics ranging from entertainment through to climate change. However, it mainly focuses on areas like stock market data, property prices, inflation, and logistics. Because most of the data on the portal is updated monthly, and in some cases daily, you'll always have new data to work with. Data.gov. In 2015, the US government made all its data publicly available. With over 200,000 datasets ranging from climate change to crime, there's guaranteed to be something you'll find interesting. For a government website, it has some surprisingly user-friendly search features, including the ability to filter by geographical area, organization type, and file format. UCI Machine Learning Repository. If you're looking for something more niche, check out the UCI Machine Learning Repository. Launched 30 years ago, but don't let the 90s vibe mislead you, the UCI Repository has a strong reputation amongst data scientists and data analysts alike. It's the go-to place for machine learning data. Datasets are clearly categorized by task, attribute, data type, and area of expertise. This makes it easy to find something suitable, no matter what sort of project you're working on. Earth data. If you think space is awesome, and let's be frank, space is awesome, look no further than the Earth data. Available since 1994, this repository gives you access to all of NASA's satellite observation data for our little blue planet. There's plenty to peruse, from weather and atmospheric observations through to climate measurements, ocean temperatures, vegetation mapping, and much, much more. Gapminder. According to the main page of the Gapminder website, you are probably wrong about your assumptions across a host of issues, ranging from global warming, female bosses, plastic in oceans, and more. Put together by Hans and Ola Rosling, these datasets are ideal for challenging those assumptions, as well as building awesome data analytic projects along the way. Also, go check out Hans Rosling's TED Talk on population rates to see how an awesome data analytics presentation can go. CERN Open Data Portal. Want to demonstrate your ability to work with highly complex datasets? Head to the CERN Open Data Portal. It offers access to over 2 petabytes of information, including data from the Large Hadron Collider. Frankly, these aren't for the faint of heart, but if you're interested in particle physics, go check it out. In many cases, they even provide sample code for you to get started with. Thanks, CERN. BFI Film Industry Statistics. If you're looking for data that's a little more digestible than particle physics, look no further than the BFI Film Industry Statistics. Throughout the year, the BFI collects data on a range of topics, from UK box office numbers to audience demographics, home entertainment, movie production costs, and more. The best part though is their annual statistic yearbook. This breaks down the year's data with some great visualizations, awesome for inspiration if you're new to data analytics. One final caveat, although all of these resources are free to access, a small portion of the datasets may have fees associated with them. And there you have it. Now you have more than enough free resources for your own data analytics portfolio projects. Not sure where to start with building your own portfolio or working with all this data? Don't worry, we've got you covered. Career Foundry has a great free short course on data analytics you can sign up for and start learning now. The link for that is in the description below. I've also made a video recently where I explain how I would go through the process of becoming a data analyst if I was going to start again in 2022. It's definitely going to be super valuable and useful, so check it out here somewhere and stay tuned for more videos in the future. I'll see you there.